Hey guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. I feel like it's been an eternity since I've been on here. Actually, it might be last week, but I don't know. Welcome back. Thank you for tuning in. Today we are in Las Vegas, Nevada. We are in this amazing facility called Savage Fitness. Thank you to my boy Chris and Arthur, my friend behind the camera, for letting me into this amazing place, little hidden spot. I absolutely love it. So I just finished my 30 minutes of cardio. So if you guys follow along, I'm currently prepping for a show, for a couple show at least. I'll talk about it later, but I do have a show coming next week. So with that being said, I was on 90 minutes of cardio a day and eating only fish. And today I checked in with James this morning at 129, which is like the lightest I've been in forever, in a very, very long time. So hit a new low this morning, so we finally feel like we're at a good place. So not only did my cardio get regressed to only 230 minutes, so an hour total a day, and a lighter cardio, no more step meal, no more crazy running, so just walking on the treadmill, incline. But we also have a little bit of food today, a little bit more, like 100 grams of rice more, which is, to me, everything. So with that being said, it's hot in Vegas, obviously. And yeah, just finished cardio, I'm all sweaty. We're gonna go over there, just get my drink ready, my little HD intra-workout situation. I'm gonna bring you guys along. And we're gonna start a back workout today. So I'm gonna train back, which is one of my favorite, one of my most challenging days, just because I don't have a big, my muscle connection when it comes to back, so it's always very, very challenging for me. But I've worked with Aldo on this, and it helped me a ton to just have that connection, have that buzz flow, and how to create that. So I'll be training solo today, but the thing with Aldo is that wherever you go, you kind of earn that, you know, that Iron University status, where it's like, it's within you. So wherever you go after that, whatever gym location, you just bring that with you, that knowledge, and you can just apply it to your training. So I'm excited to do that. I'm gonna do a lot more cable work today. So with that being said, we are exactly 2 weeks out as of today from my next show, like exactly 12 days. So things are getting a little bit, you know, obviously tiring and what's not, but today's an exciting day, and I'm just excited to bring you guys along. So we're traveling, so that's what happens when I travel. I just ziplock my supplements. So here I have 10 grams of glutamine along with 1 scoop of aminos. And this is my only drink that I have with sucralose all day. Sucralose meaning sweeteners. I don't do sweeteners, I cut everything. And we're gonna cut these about, I wanna say, what day is it today, Monday? Probably, I'm seeing James today. He's flying to Vegas, I'll talk about it later too. But probably gonna cut that very soon, so I'm trying to not take it all at the same time, if that makes sense. So I'm just gonna pour a little bit inside that cup. Keep some for later. I don't know if that's weird, but that's just for recovery purposes, just because I'm such on low calories and I'm still trying to train hard, and it's just very important to assure that those muscles are repaired, especially coming that close to a show. That's also one of the reasons why we're not doing any crazy cardio at the moment. No more, you know, things that creates a lot of inflammation, because we're that close to a show. I love empty gyms. I never thought I would say that, because, you know, I train and work at gyms, very commercial gyms, and I thought I loved having a crowded gym, but since that I'm not in crowded gyms anymore, and I go to crowded gyms, I'm like, oh my god, can I not go into crowded gyms anymore? So, like, very happy to have this entire place for almost our own today, so it's good vibe. We'll be right back. want to test my strength as well as stretching and warming up and what's not. So I did 10 to 12 reps, and then I stretch and hold in the stretch position for 3 seconds, and then for that for 3 reps.
often are you off of prep in a year?
It always depends on like the show dates, right? So technically the Arnold is always in March and then the Olympia always in September. So you're always in prep 16 weeks prior to that of both shows. That's really what separates both, not season, but then you want to get qualified and if you get invited to the Arnold, you either do like shows around this area, and most of the big shows are around March, April. With that being said, COVID, everything changes, especially this year. Now that they have the Arnold literally 2 weeks before the Olympia, which is, for competitors, it's great, don't get me wrong, but we only had 8 months of off season technically, because there's only 8 months between Olympia of last year and Olympia this year, 2021. But for those who don't need the long off season, it's great. But I've been in prep since February, if that makes sense, what I'm saying. I'm so mixed up with my time, but I've been off prep for like a good 3 months, because I remember I've been able to eat a little bit, rest a little bit more. I always train. I keep my training regimen very, very strict just because I love training. I do it all the time, but obviously the training changes. I don't do as much cardio, and obviously I have a lot of freedom in when it comes to food. I love food. So yeah, but only 3 months I think this year, but it was enough. Like, I just came back, off prep very, very slowly, kind of cutting a cookie or two a day. And it was a pretty smooth process, but now to stay for a very long time, like doing shows after shows, that's what kind of hits you. But I love it. I only have, 4 weeks and then 6 weeks before the Olympia. It's gonna come so fast, and I'm doing a show in between all that. The reason why I'm doing a show in 2 weeks is just to get another feedback. So you guys know I come back from my pro win in Chicago, a physique that I've been working so hard for, that I was so proud of. But there was a lot of adjustments to that physique, even though I won. So I got my feedback. Then I try to apply those feedbacks a week or two later to show up in Tampa. Didn't work out as much, as I thought we would. So now we're just taking those feedbacks from Tampa, from Chicago, just to mingle those two together. And I changed all my workout regimen, all my cardio regimen, my diet, obviously. And here we are in 2 weeks. We're gonna show up again from the same judge panel and be like, okay, is that what we want for the Arnold and then the Olympia? So that way we have the correct idea of where we stand, how they want me to show up for the Arnold and the Olympia, and just cruise in. It sounds stressful, but it's for very good purposes. And I love doing shows. with some pull downs, white grip pull down on the cable machine, and then I'm gonna, what's missing? A high row, so a high booty row, lighter weight, three sets for each exercise, and then that's a wrap. Try this clean place today. It's not ideal, but I ran out of tilapia earlier. I had like, this whole bag full of tilapia, and I think I only had like 50 grams or something, so I'm just gonna go to that place and see what's up. Apparently it's clean, so we're gonna make it work. I have my scale with me, and yeah, let's go eat.